That's right, you told me that he had a spider, but it wasn't cancer.
Hi, everyone. I want to welcome everyone here today. For those that don't know me, I'm Ron Friedman. I'm the president of the Jewish Federation of Fort Wayne. And I think we're in for a real treat today with the program, and thank you very much for coming out. Just a little bit of information about the program. We'll be having today, they're called the Tzofim Friendship Caravan. Tzofim is the Hebrew word for Israeli scouts. It was formed in 1973 when a group of the scouts toured the U.S. with performing arts and Israel culture program. It's now in its 43rd year, and it's grown to 3 traveling groups, and this, I believe, is the Southeast traveling group. Thousands of teenagers audition for the opportunity to perform in the caravan, and each chapter has the opportunity to nominate participants. They undergo thorough singing and dancing auditions. They're evaluated based on English competency and maturity. Once selected, they spend over 5 months training and preparing for the show and learning what it means to represent Israel as a shliach, as an emissary. This year, the theme is My Startup Nation, and the members of the caravan will share personal stories about their families, whom they consider to be their personal startup nation. Through these narratives, as well as interactive songs and dances, the caravan will hopefully connect with all of you and also bring you a taste of Israel to our community. I want to thank the Jewish Federation of Fort Wayne, the Community Relations Council, the committee of the Jewish Federation, and also the Salem Foundation for sponsoring and helping to put on the program. And also I want to thank all of you who provided home hospitality for the young teenagers that came in yesterday. So let's get started with the show. Thank you again for coming.
Maya. to tell you a short story of my family, my startup nation. My family believes that everyone has to do at least one thing for the society. And I think that what makes Israel a startup nation. Have you ever thought about it? How Israel, such a young nation of only 8 million citizens, started more startup companies than many leading world powers, such as Japan, India, Canada, and the UK? In Israel, there is a special combination of innovation and entrepreneurship in every industry. It makes us think that Israel is not only a country, it is a way of thinking and a way of life. Tonight we try and share it with you through the songs and our personal stories. We hope that you enjoy the show and feel free to sing and dance with us. During the show, I'm gonna dance with you.
Take them out, and what you'll do is you'll get into this site, kahoot.it,
and you'll enter this game pit, which will connect you to the game itself. This is a trivia-based game that we're going to play together, and this is a competition, and there is going to be a winner. So you need to be very focused, very quick, and very good. All right, so the pin is 775126. 775126. Let's see, do we have anyone in? So let's say this again. You'll need to enter this site, kahoot.it. Okay, here's Josh. Where's Josh? Good job, Josh. Wendy? All right. So we have two players in. Let's see. Anyone from this side? All right, three players. Chris? Chris. Awesome. So let me ask you a question. Has anyone been to Israel before? Okay, we have a few of you who are supposed to be good at this now. Okay, four players. Where's Leah? Hi, Leah. We'll start the game in about a minute. Let's try to log in as many players as we can. Awesome. Where's Merv? There we go. Are we ready to start, or are we waiting for more people?
21 minutes.
We'll give you one more minute. There's nobody. Nobody's playing. Fran? All right. Are ready to start? Let's begin the game. The first question is going to pop up pretty quickly, so you need to be very focused. Let's begin. Here's the first question. Question number one. How many years of independence did Israel celebrate in May 2016? You're going to have four different answers. There is 48 in red, 58 in blue, 68 in yellow, and 78 in green. Now, you have four different answers and you need to pick the correct one. You have nine answers in. Let's see, we have five more seconds. Four, three, two, one. And the correct answer is 68 years. Let's see, Stephanie, you've got that correct. Give yourself a round of applause. Let's see, you got this first. Nobody, where are you? Okay, let's move to the next question. How many people live in Israel today? Here we go. Red, 8.5 million. Blue, 6 million. Yellow, 7.5 million. And green, 10 million. Let's see, is it 10 million? Is it 6 million? We have 7 more seconds and 11 answers in. The correct answer is 8.5 million. That's 12 of you. Good job, guys. You're wonderful. I don't think we've had this before. And Leah, you got this correct. With 1,807 points, Leah is at the top. Let's go to the next question. How many startup companies were established in Israel in 2015? Let's see, we have 800 in red, 600 in blue, 1,000 in yellow, and 1,400 in green. This is a very interesting subject, and I recommend you check it out. There are many very special startup companies and inventions that were in Israel. We have 1,400 startup companies. If you got that correct, that is impressive. Let's see who got it first. Leah, you're still on top. Good job. Give her a round of applause. 2,630 points. Let's move to the next question. Which state is almost the same size as Israel? Now, this is in the United States, and I'll give you a clue. Israel is about 7 hours driving from one end to the other. So if you make the calculation, you'll figure this one out. We have 12 more seconds. Is it New York? Is it New Jersey? Is it Maine? Maybe it's Michigan. 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is New Jersey. 10 of you got that right. That is very good. Let's see who's on top. Leah, you're still on top. Let's see if anyone can pass her. 3,584 points. Which of the following was not invented in Israel? So we spoke about the startup companies. Here are some Israeli inventions. Three of these were invented in Israel and one was not. Is it the cherry tomato, the USB drive, the waste app, or the solar panels? We have 7 more seconds, 6 answers in. This one's a difficult one. 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is the solar panel. How many of you have got that right? 3. Let's see. Jackie, you're on top. Where are you, Jackie? Congratulations. 4,396 points. Let's move to the next question. This will be our last question. Which song represented Israel in the 2015 Eurovision Song Contest? Was it Hatikva? Was it Diva? Was it Jerusalem of gold or was it Golden Boy? These are the four answers. We have four answers in. 8 more seconds. Let's see who of you will win this game. Who will get it first? The answer is Golden Boy. 2 of you got that correct. Let's see who is our big winner. Leah, give her a round of applause. Congratulations, Leah. You're our winner. And this song is actually the song that we're about to sing next. This song was sung by Nadav Gedge in the Eurovision Song Contest last year when he was only 16 years old. We believe Nadav is what makes Israel a startup music nation. This is how we do it. Mama, someone broke my heart again. Tell her I don't think I can take it anymore. Mama, someone broke my heart again. Now I'm gonna ease my pain, dancing on the floor.
Dance company, and many others have become a second name
for excellence, imagination, and influence in the international dancing world, and have inspired me to exceed in what I do today. Throughout the years, these groups have grown and developed their own stats with countless shows, leading them to perform throughout Israel and the world, leaving their audiences touched and moved. In the group that I dance with, I love when we dance the hora. The songs, the moves, the circles, it all reminds me of home, reminds me of my roots. It's a dance that was taught throughout the generations, and my friends and I would like to share some of our passion and excitement as we bring to you a collection of the Jerusalem hora songs. So don't be shy and join us. Caravan, are you ready?
Yes!
Let's go!
Thank you. I don't understand much. Do you know what she asked? Boy, what they're trying to say, you know I don't understand.
Oy vey, oy vey, what chutzpah you have. It's such a shande that we can't speak Yiddish together. It's time that you learn Yiddish.
I know, Bube, you're right. How do you feel?
Not ay ay ay, not as a good, aber no schön. Enjoy my shining care, my tire. It was good to hear from you.
Abigasud, Bube?
See? Du verstehst doch Yiddish. You understand some Yiddish. Thank you, mein Schöner. Adank dir, sei gesund und stark. And enjoy the rest of your travel. Bye.
Bye, Bube, bye. Wonderful, Brendan. Now, after we spoke with her, will you help me sing a song that she used to sing to me? Will you?
Yes.
Thank you. Please, join us.
And as the leading civil engineer, he planned and built many cities in Israel, like Carmiel, Be'er Sheva, and even Tel Aviv. My great-grandfather managed to build not only a large number of cities in Israel, but he also rebuilt his own family, and was the proud great-grandfather of 12 young great-grandchildren, including myself. I was lucky that he got to see me grow, and to have him in my life until he passed away when he was 95 years old. He used to tell me that seeing us, his grandchildren, living free and happy life in Israel, is his great triumph over the Nazis. Family meant everything to my great-grandfather. And I would like to dedicate the next song, Ve'ishe Amda, to him and to all of his generation who made Israel a startup nation.
Thank you.
means repair the world, and it's everything we do in order to make the world a better place. We try to include at least a little tikkun olam in whatever we do, no matter how big or small. For example, the volunteer work I do with Tzofim in my community, and even when I visit my grandma and read her in the newspaper. For me, these are both examples of tikkun olam. Before we began our journey to the United States, we met a group of young adults from the Tzofim Garim Tzavar program. This program supports extraordinary young adults who decide to make aliyah and join the IDF. Growing up, I always knew that when I graduated high school, I would serve in the IDF. Therefore, I was fascinated by them and admired their decision, their courage to leave their family, friends, and everything they knew behind to join the army and protect the Jewish nation. Tzofim Garim Tzavar makes it easier for these young teenagers by creating a group of peers who make aliyah together, support each other, and go through this process all together. For me, they are the ultimate example of tikkun olam. They are my startup nation. This next song is about these special teenagers, but it's also about all of us. It's about how you and I can change the world. Ani v'atan nishaneh et ha'olam. Thank you.
Israel.
Many of us grew up with Jewish songs and tefillot, playing in their house or in camps. Throughout the years, Jewish singers from all over the world have given their own twist to everyday songs that are part of our culture and religion. One of the artists who does it the best is Gad Elbaz, and he is the singer of our next song. I'm sure many of you will recognize the next song immediately, and we have a special request. We need your help. We want all of you to dance with us the next song. So first, I want to call to the stage two of my friends, Gad and Noah, come up to the stage so they can help me to teach you the next dance. So everybody, please stand up. Okay, so we're going to teach you a few steps from the dance, so repeat after us. The first few steps goes like this. We're going to tap on our thigh, and then we're going to clap our hands. We're going to do this twice, so let's do it together. Tap. Great. Now to the next part. We're going to roll our hands to one side and then roll our hands to the other side. Let's try from the beginning. And tap, 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 tap. Roll and roll. Good job, guys. I think you're ready for the last part of the dance. The last part goes like this. We're going to raise our hands up high and wave them in the sky. So now we're going to dance the whole dance from the beginning to the end. On three. One, two, three, and tap, 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 tap. Roll and roll. Raise your hands high and wave them in the sky. Wow, good job, everyone. I think now you're ready for the next dance. Caravan, are you ready?
Yes!
Let's celebrate the Haba Megillah.
Bye.
again and enjoy the rest of the show. Hi everyone, you guys enjoying the show so far? Come on, I can't hear you. Are you enjoying the show so far? So my name is Maya, and I live in a small town called Gdeot. Through our life stories and our favorite songs, we try to show you our love for Israel. But honestly, I am blown away standing here and seeing your love for Israel. It's beautiful to see how we can come together despite the thousands of miles between our two countries. This reminds me of a saying in Hebrew, "Al tachafes rachok, tishaer karov," which translates, "Don't search far, stay close." It's a funny translation, but means that despite the distance, Israel is still nearby, in your hearts. I want to dedicate this next song to all of you. May we remain close, no matter the distance. And may we keep making new memories together.
You said one day.
Joining the project. Actually, they were all selected out of 3,000 kids because of their
amazing personality because they are all good counselors in the Israeli Scouts Youth Movement, and they've worked extremely hard to get this show ready for you. How hard? Think about it. They are all in high school. They are all going to study between Sunday till Friday. Then Friday at noontime, they took the bus, came to Tel Aviv for Friday and Saturday, practiced 10 hours of singing and dancing a day, and then on Sunday morning, they came back to their school to study. They did it for about 6 months, since the last January, and they haven't stopped working since we came here. Now, throughout the show, they try to tell you about their startup nation. And if you think about it, putting everything that they are doing requires a lot of chutzpah, self-belief, ruach, energy, and a lot of very special personality. And if you ask me, I personally believe that youth like this is what makes Israel a startup nation, and I'm extremely proud to be the leader. Now, thank you. And we've been traveling for almost 2.5 months now, 2 months, and we've drove 9,000 miles. We've been into, I think, almost 60 different communities. We've seen at least 15 different doctors. We've broke 3 bones, 2 of them are mine. And we weren't able to do all of this without the womb communities that host us, a lot of Jewish mothers, and especially people like Jackie, who make us, who help us make these shows happen. Jackie, I'd like to invite you up to the stage so I can take you personally, if you can join me here. So first of all, Toda Rabba, we really appreciate you inviting us. And I have 2 small presents that I'd like to leave you with as a token of our appreciation. The first one is the CD of our show. Basically, we already ran out of CDs like 2 weeks ago, and we left this one especially for you because we know it's your first time with the Caravan, so it's a collector's edition. I hope you enjoy it. It has all of our 12 songs. And there is one more small gift that I'd like to give to you. As you can see, everyone in the Israel Scout has a neckerchief. The kids have one, it means they are leaders. I have a different one, it means I'm the leader of the leaders. And I'm gonna give you a white and purple one, which basically means that you're a big shot in the Israeli Scouts. Now, in order for me to give it to Jackie, she's not just going to give it like just like this, I need your help. We're gonna count together till 3 in Hebrew. Do you know how to do it? Let me hear that. Repeat after me. Achat. Shtaim. Shalosh. We're gonna do it one more time. This time when we finish, you're gonna clap your hands in appreciation for everything that Jackie has been doing, and you're gonna be officially a part of the Israeli Scouts family. Are you ready for it? Are you ready for it?
Yes!
Let's try! There is one more thing that I'd like to tell you before we continue with the show. I don't know if you know it, but the Scouts are a non-profit organization, and the Israeli Scouts are no different. And in order for us to keep this project running year after year after year, we need your support. Right over there, there is a small merchandise table, a donation table, that will sell t-shirts and patches from our show, and we also have a small donation box. Whatever you can put in to help us keep this project running will be very much appreciated. We will really be thankful for your partnership. Now, I think I've talked enough. Are you ready to continue the show?
Yes.
Caravan, are you ready?
Yes!
That's my favorite part. It's the last 2 songs, so enjoy it. Caravan, let's go!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Donation area. We hope to see you next year. Shalom!